Thank you very much, Honorable Speaker, and the leadership of the EFF. This is a motion that seeks to unite black people in South Africa. And ordinarily, if leadership was provided, we shouldn't be having this debate, because the land should have been returned into the hands of the rightful owners. We all know that the Dutch gangsters arrived here and took our land by force. And the struggle has since been about the return of the land into the hands of rightful owners. Yet those who went to negotiate on behalf of our people during the negotiations sold out this fundamental principle which constituted the struggle against colonialism. So those who claim to be radical enough and who want radical change today should actually be in the forefront of agreeing that this constitution must be changed to make it possible for our people to own the land. It can't be correct that the less than 10% of the population owns almost more than 75% of the land. And those people who own the land happen to be, in an acceptable language, private people like individuals, trusts, and companies. But when you search deep as to who are these people, these are white people who are still owning our land. We remain a conquered nation, even when we claim to have democracy. We remain a conquered nation because white monopoly capital still owns the means of production, and at the center of that is the land question. The dominance of white people, it cannot go away, particularly white supremacy, for as long as land is not returned into the hands of the people. We are the only country where we say revolution has taken place, yet those who are oppressing us have not lost anything after the revolution. We remain as we were even before 1994. So we are saying that black people, all of us, we need to unite and amend the constitution so that we can expropriate land without compensation. There is no white person who will understand that clarion call, because they don't know the pain of being landless. Only those who have gone through a passage of being landless will appreciate where we come from on the issue of the land. The issue of the land cannot be a campaigning issue. The issue of the land cannot be a rhetorical question. The issue of the land should be an issue of commitment. Honorable members, we have taken an oath here. And when we take an oath, we are simply saying we are loyal to the land. But how can we be loyal to the land which is in the hands of private individuals? We must be loyal to the land that belongs to us. Majority of our people say South Africa belongs to them, yet they do not have proof to show that indeed South Africa belongs to them, because many of them do not even know how a title deed looks like. Many generations died without even knowing how a title deed looks like. It is only through the expropriation of land without compensation that our people will be the rightful owners of this country. We cannot keep on saying South Africa belongs to all who live in it, yet we have nothing to show. Today, the ANC should come with the EFF. There is 6% available. We give it to you without no condition to amend the constitution and take the land. If you don't agree with us today, it means you are disagreeing with Honorable Ayanda Dlodlo. If we don't agree with us today, it means you don't agree with your outgoing president on the issue of expropriation of land without compensation, even the Minister of Land. This is a matter that can unite black people. This is a matter that all of us should stand together and isolate white monopoly capital. This is a matter that can say to us, This is a genuine call which we as black people can identify with. So the ANC 6% shona rele fa yona arjeng le fase releming arjeng le fase ra ga di feme arjeng le fase re fe batho ba rena ba be le magae ba be le a place to call home. Honorable Nzimande, we have already started taking the land. If you vote against this, it's a waste of time. We are already giving our people the land, and we are not ashamed of that. People of South Africa, where you see a beautiful land, take it, it belongs to you.
Honorable Ngwenya Mabila.